What's up, guys? In today's video, we're going to be reacting to the brand new, just announced FNAF Help Wanted 2 official teaser trailer. Yes, you guys heard those words correct. I can't even believe what I'm just saying, like what I just said, because earlier this week, or, you know, a few weeks ago, we got the FNAF movie trailer, early, insane. Then this week, we got the FNAF Ruin trailer, and now we have FNAF Help Wanted 2, the official trailer for the game, and all these games are releasing this year. We have Ruin coming out in a few months. We have this game, apparently, from what I heard, it's releasing at the end of this year. And yeah, and then the movie, of course, in October. This has been an insane year for FNAF fans so far. It's been quiet, you know, up until this point, but now we just have news after news after news after news. It's insane. All I'm gonna say, though, before we end this, subscribe right now if you're new. You will not regret it. You will see all of the games on here, maybe even a little bit early if I get them sent early. And yeah, get subscribed. Anyways, let's go ahead and give this a watch and see what it has in store for us.
Welcome back for another week of career fulfillment and minimal social interaction.
We're going into sister location.
We know how challenging it can be to find a place where you feel that you truly belong. And to find a job that treats you mostly with respect and only infrequently with contempt.
Mostly with respect. For that
reason, we are excited to inform you that you did an adequate enough job the first time around to have you back.
This is cool. So wait.
Also, there were no other applicants. So strap yourself in and get motivated to an appropriate degree.
This is awesome.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Wow, man, seeing sister location like that? I know it said it wasn't actual gameplay, but that looks gorgeous. It looks gorgeous. Help Wanted to. Yeah, that's cool. So do we get a release date, though? I heard it's end of the year. Oh, we get a jump scare. Okay, cool. Late 2023. Oh man, that's cool. I cannot believe that we're actually getting another FNAF game. Like, that's crazy. And this is made by Steel Wool Studios, I'm assuming, right? I mean, they made the first one. So they were working on Ruin and this at the same time. I guess they have two different, you know, parts of the company working on different games. I don't know, but wow, this looks good. This looks really good. It's a very short teaser, a little under a minute, but I mean, that's kind of like everything we've had this year, or, you know, so far. Like, the FNAF movie teaser trailer is really short, the Ruin trailer really short, so I mean, this one's no exception. And it's just to kind of show off that it is coming, I guess. It's probably early on in development, because it does say, like, later this year, so maybe, you know, they're still working things out, so they don't want to show too much, but this is exciting for a few reasons, though. First of all, another game, another FNAF game this year, but it also shows that we might be getting some more trailers, because, I mean, they showed off a very early version of this game right now, so we might eventually get a trailer for the full game, which will show off a lot more, which who knows when that could come out, but very exciting. Okay, so let's go ahead and go frame by frame here. So obviously we're heading into sister location, we're going down the giant elevator that we all know and love, and like graphically, like I said, it looks great. Graphically, it looks very impressive. Now it's not gameplay, it says right there on the bottom, not actual gameplay, but I mean, if they come anywhere close to this, wow, like, it looks promising. I mean, obviously sister location was only made by Scott, one person, so, you know, they could, this is a whole team working on this game, so it could look gorgeous with a bunch of people. But regardless, you got a poster of Circus Baby on the top right there that just says stay cool, and it has Circus Baby trying to hand out an ice cream. Now, you all know, if there's one animatronic that you do not grab ice cream from, well, I wouldn't grab it from any of the animatronics, but Circus Baby is the one that you do not absolutely go anywhere near, because obviously her chest will open up and she will swallow you whole. And yeah, I have a feeling we're probably going to be seeing that little scene in VR in this game. Now, the phone guy, or I don't know what you'd want to call him, I guess hand unit, he actually comes in and does mention that this is the same character as the first game, which I find very surprising. But apparently it's the same guy as the first game. So let's see. We have a poster on the left right there that says Let's Play. You got Bon Bon and Bonette. Now, obviously, Funtime Freddy, all this is location animatronics are going to be coming back. Very exciting. Now, I don't know how this is going to work, though, because in the original game, you were just kind of like in different locations. Like, you were in FNAF 1, right? But then you went to this monitor, and that took you to FNAF 1, 2, 3, all of the games. FNAF 4, sister location. It took you to a wide variety of different areas, and even some new areas in the game's universe for those games, you know? So, I guess this one's gonna take place in sister location. Maybe there's, like, a monitor on a desk, and that's how, like, you know, we mostly play this game. And then, obviously, on that monitor, we can go to different game universes. Like, you know, maybe we can return to FNAF 1, FNAF 2, or we're going into the future. Maybe we're in this game, we're gonna be in FNAF 6. And of course, Ultimate Custom Night, you know, even maybe even Freddy in Space. I don't know. Maybe they can just go wild with this game and just make, you know, different mini games for all of these different games that we played through. I mean, now Security Breach is out. At the time when we were playing Help Wanted 1, that game was just a thought, you know, it wasn't even out yet. And of course, they ended up eventually hinting to it in Help Wanted with the, you know, the Pizzaplex getting built in the snowy area and stuff like that. I remember hacking that. That was so much fun. But my point is, I think in this game, they're going to take the same idea from the first game where, you know, you can go through all these different games that we've played through previously that Scott's made, FNAF 1 through 6 or whatever, and then they're going to expand it. So maybe, like I was saying, we get, you know, the games past that we didn't get in the first game, we're getting in this one. So I think Pizzeria Simulator can be an absolute blast in this game, having to deal with Scrap Baby and all those different animatronics, and even Ultimate Custom Night, if they can do something like that. I mean, yeah, we have Ultimate Custom Night VR, but that's like a fan game. But, you know, this could be a way of getting Ultimate Custom Night in VR by like an official FNAF developer. So I just think the possibilities with this are endless, and they have a bunch of stuff that they could do. Like, there's so many different mini games that they could add into this game. And also, I mean, I think it's going to be interesting in terms of the actual Easter eggs and stuff, and the return of Glitch Trap and Vanny and stuff like that, because as we know, they are tied to these games. That was our first introduction to Vanny, was in Help Wanted 1. And of course, Glitch Trap, there's multiple endings, and all of them, I want to say, Glitch Trap ends up surviving. So yeah, he's definitely going to be making a return in this game. Obviously, we don't really know what exactly could happen because we don't have the Ruin DLC. I have a feeling after Ruin DLC comes out, we're going to have a much better understanding of what we can experience in this game. But regardless, I just want to give my thoughts on this game. I'm excited. I cannot wait to see what they do with this. I always loved the first game. It was my favorite FNAF game until Security Breach, which I know that's a controversial statement for a lot of people, but I really love Security Breach. But yeah, regardless, I just love the idea of like having to be able to go back into VR, or even, I mean, it might not only be VR. We know the first game eventually came out in non-VR, so, and I don't know if it mentions actually VR anywhere in the trailer. I don't remember. I don't think it does. I'm skimming through it right now, and I don't actually think it does. So, I mean, it'd be cool to not have to sit in VR, because, like, as cool as it is, you know, it's fun to be in VR, but I think I'd prefer to, you know, just be able to play the game normally. I'm skipping to the end. So it just says FNAF Help Wanted 2, late 2023, which, by the way, that's crazy to see. But it doesn't include VR anywhere. But they did show this at the start of their PlayStation VR, you know, their newest PlayStation VR 2, whatever it's called. So my guess is you can either play in VR in PlayStation VR 2 or, you know, Oculus, whatever you have. Or you can play in non-VR. At least that's what I'm hoping. But we'll have to wait and see, because I just think if it's only in VR, it's going to keep the player base to a much smaller amount, which I think that was a problem with the first game, at least at the time. At least a lot of people didn't have VR, but nowadays I think it's more common. But regardless, I like the idea of it not being in VR, you know, having the option to, you know, turn it off and on. But regardless, that's my thoughts on the game. I'm excited. I can't wait. I hope they do this game good, because I mean, it still will. We know they will, because I mean, you gotta think, the first game was incredible, at least to me, and then the DLC was some of the best DLC we've ever had for a FNAF game. It's my favorite DLC that we've had. Obviously Ruin's coming out, but it's definitely my top DLC of all time, you know, Curse of Dreadbear. So who knows what they're gonna do with this game, but I think the opportunities here are endless, and I'm excited. Anyways, that's it. That's my thoughts on the game. I'm excited. I hope you guys are too, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out.